Hi everybody, this is Dave Blackburn here, and you're listening to The Mixtape. Natalie is going to tell us all about veganism, what it is, why she became a vegan.
Hello, this is Natalie. One way or another, I'm going to get you, I'm going to make you a vegan.
Tell us a little bit about yourself before we start talking about being a vegan.
Okay, well, I'm a holistic therapist in Glasgow, so I do holistic therapies. Various different therapies like Reiki, Indian head massage. I've got a website, Tree of Organics.
Tree of Organics.
Mm-hmm. Tree, yeah, as in
.uk?
A tree. Yeah, .co.uk.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So I've got a health blog on there, so people can come on and have a look at different things that I do, you know, recipes, health tips, offers on holistic therapy. So it's a pretty new website. It's been updated.
Okay. Tell us now. And I think everybody knows what a vegetarian is. I think some people probably think they know what a vegan is, but you tell us.
Okay, the difference is with being vegan, you don't have any animal products or any dairy. It's just purely, it's from the plant world. Mm. But it's not limited to, you know, just lettuce and things like that. It's like the full range of recipes and food choices.
So we don't eat anything from the sea either?
Nope. Fish isn't a vegetable.
Exactly. Even the sea cucumber's not a vegetable. They always bring the laugh of the vegetarians that say, yeah, I'm a vegetarian, but I eat fish. It's an animal. It's not a vegetable. But vegans...
I've had that a lot.
Vegans, they don't eat any meat, any fish. And it's not just meat, it's not just dead animals, don't eat any animal products. So no eggs, no milk.
No eggs, no milk. You don't use any animal products whatsoever, you know, so you refrain from things that have been tested on animals or leather, you know, things like that. So
you don't wear leather shoes or leather handbags?
Yeah, I wouldn't go out and buy anything new.
So, Hemp.
Yeah, hemp's a natural product. You can have that as well, like hemp seeds and hemp protein powder, you know.
It's an extremely useful plant, isn't it? I mean, it actually is a wonder plant.
Yeah, it really is a wonder plant. Mm-hmm. You can do so much with hemp, you know, clothes. You can use the plant for food, for building, you know, for everything really. So it's worth...
It's a bit of a superfood as well,
I think, it's a superfood. It's worth checking out online. You know, you can buy it locally. You can get it in, health shops and put a spoonful in a smoothie every day, and that's a great health boost.
A spoonful of hemp mix helps the world go round. I know a lot of people who keep that philosophy.
Yeah.
All right, so... How difficult is it to become a vegan?
Well, for me, what I did, I went through a transition. I was brought up eating meat, like mostly everyone, and then I just went through a natural process of gradually, like, hardly having any meat, and then it was just fish, and then it was, like, someone actually said to me, "Are you a vegetarian?" And it hadn't even occurred to me, but I was going in that direction. So that's when I decided to look into being a vegetarian and what that entailed. And it opened my eyes up to what's going on, you know, with the animals. But at that point, I had no idea about the dairy industry. I just thought, okay, I'll be vegetarian because I loved eggs, I loved cheese. And I just thought, how can you live without these kind of things? Then it was one day when I watched a film. And it was about the meat and dairy trade, like Earthlings. I recommend that people should watch Earthlings. Yeah, it's a brilliant film. It's got the actor Joaquin Phoenix, narrating it all. So
it's quite an emotional film to watch, though, isn't it?
It really will
change your view.
Changes your view. Changes your whole outlook. You know, as soon as you watch it.
Yeah.
And I'm so grateful that I managed to see it because it really did take me on this journey. You know, to where I am now. So. I had a look online. I just thought to myself, why are people vegan? You know, why are they living without milk or cheese? You know, that's not
normal. Yeah, most people think you're not normal.
And I just thought, you know, it's not doing any harm to an animal, surely. So until I typed it into the internet, good old Google, and then just discovered the grisly truth, you know,
which
about
is?
dairy. It's really dangerous, you know, not dangerous, well that is a good word to use actually. Just awful, you know, what happens to the animals. They're kept impregnated and, you know, they go through a lot of pain.
They're kept impregnated so that they'll keep producing maximum amounts of milk.
And the baby calves are taken away from their mother so that they don't have, they don't get the milk, so that it's sold to us.
And if that's a male calf?
Yeah, male calves, they're seen as a waste product, as if, you know, like a product, and so they're usually shipped off for the veal trade, you know. So I checked out online and I found a blog, How to Be Vegan, and do a 30-day, it was a 30-day trial, a vegan trial, and it was a guy from New York. So it was a really interesting blog and it really inspired me and made me feel I'll try that.
And how easy did you find it to become vegan?
Well, the trial was a bit hit and miss because I was saying to myself halfway through, oh, I'm doing really well, this is going great, this trial. And then I realised I was actually using dairy, like yogurt in my smoothie and sometimes having feta cheese. But just totally forgetting, you know, because it was old habits die hard. And then that's when I realised, oh, what am I doing? This isn't even vegan. But yeah, that's the way it's been designed from these industries who are selling us these products. It's as if we're supposed to just go and quickly pick it off of a shelf, you know. So yeah, I stopped that trial and started over again.
So you mentioned this 30-day book.
30-day
Don't mention the title of book again.
Oh, my book.
Because I know that you're in the middle of producing your own book, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm in the middle of doing that. And it's called Change Your Life in 21 Days.
That's quicker than the other woman.
The other woman was 30. It was a 30-day vegan blog. But I looked into that. I said, why 30 days? And it's, they say you can change, you know, you can make a habit and break a habit, usually within a period of a month. But in other research, I found 21 days. And I thought, I quite like that. I'm going to go with the 21. And I decided to make a diary of it. You know, it's my journey for 21 days and just giving people recipes and, you know, an inside scope on what I'm doing for those 21 days.
The other thing I want to talk about is the sustainability of the diet that we have. Climate change is happening. There are one or two people that deny it, but 99.99999% of scientists, any of those that aren't paid by the people who've got an interest in still burning fossil fuels, all say that climate change is happening and we have to do something about it now. We're going to be run short of water. The hotter the planet becomes, the more of it ends up in the atmosphere. Luckily in Scotland, I don't think it's ever going to happen, but the world is seriously running out of water.
Pigs are some of the thirstiest animals in the farm industry as well, so awesome. They're taking up even more water.
They're also some of the brainiest mammals outside the primates, pigs, very, very intelligent. So rearing them the way that we do, where it's often kept in pens, where they've not got much room to move. For an intelligent animal, you imagine being kept in a room where there wasn't even enough room to turn around. A lot of pigs live that. Natalie, who sort of inspired you into this sort of life? Who should people be looking for some guidance?
Well, I've already mentioned the film Earthlings, which can be found on YouTube. It can be found online to watch for free. So yeah, be prepared. It's, you know, it's going to just open your eyes up and your mind up to everything.
When you're not crying.
Yeah. and also, my vegan superhero is Gary Yourofsky. He is an absolute legend.
Is he an American?
He's an American, yeah. He's an animal rights activist. So he actually lectures all around America. Various schools, he goes and speaks to students and he tells them all about the whole transition of being a vegan, how to be a vegan, you know, and just how we're all brainwashed, you know, you know, into like the meat and dairy matrix.
Right.
So he's really, really amazing and I recommend looking out for him. Really for me, they were the ones that made me go vegan. Earthlings, Gary Yourofsky, he's got a video called His Best Speech Ever and it's on YouTube.
Right.
So
now, when we think of vegans and the way that they're portrayed in the media and the jokes that people make about them, you tend to think of some like skinny, ill-looking person. You know, that is the impression that the media likes to push at us. And let's not forget that, you know, we live in a world where everybody's trying to guide us one way or another. Or in not one way or another. They're all trying to guide us in one way. We all found that all that out in the last few months where the media or the whole of the establishment worked to try and stop us getting independence. They do that with everything. Everything in your life is really, you're guided, you're told to eat meat, you're told to eat all the adverts and everything. Mm-hmm. People in America, this generation now are going to be the first generation that don't live as long as the previous generation, and that's because of the diets that they are being sold. The mm-hmm. government allowing it to happen. I'm very, very passionate about the way the world run, mm-hmm. and it's not run very well. We need to take over. Children of the revolution. What sort of things do you eat? You know, I can imagine the questions that you get.
Yeah, people always ask you that. Yeah. Well, I eat fruits and vegetables and seeds and nuts, legumes.
But how do you make that? How do you make them palatable? How do you make them so? You know, people are going to think we've already got a problem, particularly in Scotland, but throughout the UK, but more in Scotland, where people don't eat enough fruit and vegetables. So, how do you make this delicious?
Yeah, that's another one. What happens is when you go vegan, you tend to become a bit of a chef. You look on. Well, I just decided to have a look at favourite recipes of mine and how to make them vegan. So I used to love macaroni and cheese, spaghetti carbonara. You know, lots of wholesome foods. So I would type into the internet, how do I make this and how do I do that, and then even find books as well. So I just you don't lose anything, you gain when you're vegan. You're gaining more, you know, like you just supplement. For example, if I don't have regular cheese, I can buy the Gusto cheese, which is a lovely vegan one. I wish I brought some with me tonight.
You can't say that. The Gusto.
I'll let you do that, Dave.
Other cheeses are available.
And you can get your own homemade cashew nut cheeses that you can do yourself from home. Mm. And it's a raw cheese, you know, a lovely...
And that's where we get proteins from if you're a vegan. I'm not a vegan, by the way. I'm not even a vegetarian, but I do really support those that are. People think you only get protein from meat. Nuts are full of protein, aren't they?
Yeah, plants in general, everything is filled with protein. That's why the animals get protein, because they eat from the plant world, and that's what you're getting when you're eating the meat and the dairy. But it all comes from the plant world, the natural earth.
We can cut out the middleman. The middle animal.
Yeah, we can.
And get our protein straight from the ground.
Straight from the sun food.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I've been also studying nutrition lately as well, and it's really fascinating. Just, you know, like getting things like your healthy fats.
Do you need to know a lot about nutrition to turn vegan?
Well, you don't really, but in a way it is helpful, yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, you'll get everything you need from the plant world anyway, as long as you're eating quite a healthy, balanced diet. I like to try and go for as much fresh food as I can, ideally organic, you know, when I find it. And you can also go to like wholesale markets as well, you know. And there's lots of places you can just find, you know, what you really need. Like for me, my staples are, I love dates, mm-hmm. and I love...
Me too.
They're so beautiful, you can make them into anything. So many amazing recipes can come out of dates. Also coconut and avocados.
I love coconut.
Yeah, and they're healthy, they're so nutritious. Mm-hmm. And they're, you know, they give you all the natural fats that your body needs, and nuts and seeds, and you'll find so many recipes on there, you know, online as well. There's just so much, you know, out there for people to find, like Meatless Mondays as well, if you want to just introduce yourself to it gradually. You can just even try one day a week and then take it from there and build it up, you know, to more days, or just go for the full out trial.